Yeah, charlatans are here, or at least, you don't need them all for this one, do you?
No.
Right, the engine room have been given the song off, right. Claire in Southampton says, can you say hi to the band? The new album is the best yet.
Brilliant.
You know? So I was at the front on someone's shoulders at Isle of Wight Festival. I don't know whether that means it was someone she knew or she just climbed on top of them. I'm still grinning now, but there you go. So the new album, Up at the Lake. I was saying, is this Pick Me a Lake?
It is, yeah.
Is it?
Photograph on the front.
In Cheshire, right. Lots of questions coming in. This one says, have the Charlatans been listening to ELO while writing the new album? Not knocking them like, just wondering.
For the single, maybe, yeah.
Did you? Oh, right. That's from Mr. Jeff Lynn. Sent that one. You heard you've been away and done the traditional thing, haven't you, and go away to a cottage in the country to write things. Was that right?
Yeah.
Did you?
Talk about that, Mark.
Well, myself and Tim went away for.
Where was the cottage in the country?
It was on the top of a hill in Bodmin Moor.
Lovely.
Sort of like 6 months before that, we'd tried going over to LA, and I went over there for about 3 weeks.
Right.
And we ended up writing about one and a half songs in about a month.
Right. Why was that? Too many distractions?
You know it.
I don't, actually. I've never been, so...
Well, don't go.
Right.
If you want to write songs right. quickly.
I don't need to write songs.
But we decided we'd try an isolated atmosphere.
Right.
We came away with, 10 songs in 10 days.
Great. All right.
On Bodmin Moor.
Well, yeah. Brilliant, you know. What is it, just an acoustic, but except for all your pedals and pods and...
And a big black panther who was stalking around the house.
Oh, right. So, okay, right.
That's
excellent.
Awesome.
Excellent. Now, this is... I don't know whether this is quite fair, whether the others are all in, but I'll ask, I can ask Martin and John later. This is a good question from Nicola Hurd, and I want an honest answer. Who is the first one of you to usually get a round of drinks in at the bar?
It's not mine.
And who is the most likely not to bother? Which answers the second part, really. Although Martin's not here, so...
I know he's tying his shoelaces, which is what he usually does when he goes into a pub.
Right, well, leave that one at that. And you might want to think about this one. So if you weren't in the Charlatans, what other band would you like to have been in? Past or present. Would it have been in the Rolling Stones, Mark? I've just seen pictures of you with Ronnie Wood. Where was all that?
I know. Well, he's put me off, though, now.
Has he?
I don't know.
Right. So.
Classic rock and roll bands, yeah.
Well,
that's quite nice.
Yeah. You don't know.
Anything from the 60s, you know.
Right, yeah. Okay, fine, all right. Anyway...
1860s.
You what?
1860s.
Right, so you're going to do us a sensitive moment now. I'm just guessing this with the absence of the bass player and drummer, who've gone to the bar to get a cheap round in while you three are in here. No, they haven't. They threw there. But they are drinking. okay, so another track from the album. Tim, what's it going to be? Mark.
It's called Dead Love.
Okay, right.
And it goes a little something like this.
Lovely.
How can you say my
Dead Love, The Charlatans. Is that one? Did you play that live much? Or,
done it a couple of times.
Done it a couple of times, yeah.
He was reading the word. Ian Ferry's been on, said, when are you doing a tour? Is there any plan to do a tour of album tracks rather than having to do all the greatest hits? I mean, it's like, how do you change the set all the time? You put kind of, you know, yeah. You can't, I mean, no one, everyone, you can never keep everyone happy, have you? Say, no. Do some of the ones we know, and then they write in saying, do all the ones we know.
We've changed it around quite a lot on this tour.
Yeah.
We did two gigs in London, I think. Two dates in London and Islington where we played the whole of this record. And
right.
People got bored halfway through, so we had to do some hits and stuff.
Well, Keely Brenner says, would you ever consider doing a pure forum fan gig? Like, i.e. we choose the set list for you to play.
No.
No, okay, that's fair enough. And, I've got so many bits of paper here. Where's that other one? That was someone was asking you. Tim, what was your blazer and medal about at the Liverpool gig?
It was all about D-Day.
Oh, well, of course, right, okay. You don't strike as the kind of man who possesses a blazer. Have you bought one now, or did you borrow it?
Oh, D-Day was last week, I think, somewhere. Was it? Yeah, I've got, it's like a nice sort of like corduroy jacket.
Oh, well.
And put a medal on it, and, you know, I felt a bit like Pete Townsend for a bit.
Job done. And Rob Giles says, can you ask the scrumptiously cool Charlatans, boats or wheelbarrows?
Boats.
Yeah, it's got to be boats, hasn't it? That's an easy one. Yeah, all right then. So, Charlatans performing live. We've got one more song to go from the new album, Up at the Lake, which we'll bring you in the last half hour. This is Prince.